Hello and welcome back to FIFA Manager 2020 here at Rawslowgaming and our fourth season in Vanara National League South with Bath City Football Club, where we're trying to take them to the top of Premier League and beyond. And well, we had another bad start of the season here, but yeah, we're doing our best to trying to turn things around here, and next up is a match against Concord Rangers, and we will be pretty even Steven in terms of a team rating here. As you will see here, we are at 543 versus their 551. We are playing at home, so hopefully we can take advantage of that. And we will do instant result here for this match, and we'll do at least one 3-day match in this episode. And we're starting off extremely poorly with the two goals against us in the first 11 minutes, but we do get in with our reduction just before the end of the first half. So the scoreline then is, of course, after one half, a 1-2 for Bath City versus Concord Rangers. Halftime talk. I know you can do better. They can do better, of that I'm sure. Atmosphere are down to 3. So, yeah. And teamwork at 66. So, pretty darn horrific. And we need to take a look at, well, anything to up the atmosphere within the team, which will be very well and needed since we're losing this match also. The end. Scoreline is 1-2 after full time for Bassett versus Concord Rangers. Shots 4-5, shots on target 2-3, chances 4-5, and possession 49-51%. So pretty bad and pretty, well, not, I wouldn't say undeserved, but a bit unlucky maybe. We could have gotten away with more for sure. Still 19th in the league, 8 points up to a playoff spot. And guessing we will drop more in sports. I think we are down to 8th, yeah. And we're having two tough matches up ahead here before we are having an easier match. And the easier matches haven't really gone our way either here so far this season, which is very frustrating. The reserves team actually also losing 1-2 for versus Concord Rangers. Actually meeting the same team there, same team there exactly the same time for the reserves. I don't think that's so usual, but it happened there anyway. So we do have, or we have gotten in a lot more scouting opportunity and in general a lot more stuff for this season. But so far it haven't really been in any advantage at all. So see here, two more hard matches. And then things are looking up, hopefully. So we will do a player party here after these two hard matches. Don't want to do it too early, since we have had quite many events regarding just that. Craig wants to improve. He isn't really improving so far this season, so we should tell him to give more in training or something like that. And let's see here. Balance or stronger. Balance, crosses or strengths. So a lot of things we could tell him to train, and balance is pretty poor. Crossing is, well, not poor as such, and strength. Well, he doesn't need strength as such, so I think we'll go with balance there to tell him to train. All right, and he took that hint positive, so that's good. We should take a look at scouting here, and our youth scouting. Donate kickabout area. Oh, I don't know if we can afford 12k. We'll monitor our league, or the scout will monitor our league. Everything to increase our knowledge, so to say. And we'll say, give it your best here. Our team rating down to 527. Actually, 18th best in the league, so definitely one of the worst in the league. So can't be too unhappy with that. And somehow we're actually leading here after one half. 1-0 for Basic versus Welling United. And overall, it looks like all the players are having quite a good game. And we'll say, let's continue like this. Atmosphere still at 3 teamwork, up to 72 here. Somehow, don't know exactly why, but doesn't really matter. We're starting to hope that we could hold it together, but no, got a goal against us, but we managed to get a draw here, at least against Welling United, and I would take that as a win for sure. So the end result for Basic versus Welling United is a 1-1. Shots 2-4, shots on target 2-3, chances 3-4, and possession 43-57%. So quite a well for sure. And overall, good performance by the lads, actually. Still in a 19th place, 9 points off from a playoff spot. And we are creating very few chances here. Even worse than last year around. But of course, we are in a pretty poor state at the moment. But I know we can do better if we're just getting some atmosphere and some trust into the players. I know we are a decent team and should be able to do something good. 5.39 in team rating now. And Dulwich Hamlet is having a bad season so far. We are having, yeah, Simpson out, so we have 10 more in rating to get or something like that. So we are about 5.50, really. Oh, and so many males here. Due to, well, our assistant manager and our youth manager switching things up, but that's good. The Shara gaining experience level, that's also really good. That will mean, yeah, it's up to 52. It's actually a minus one only in experience level. And Schultz, that's really good, up to level 2, so he's 52. Shuki Simple wants to be a playmaker. Well, you can complain all you want. You're not really going to get what you want because you are not really our first pick anyway for a center midfielder. You need to develop a fair bit more. But then again, he do need experience to do that, and that will be better. Reach some training objective, each player, so that's good. I think we will see that more. Jonas Simpson. Well, you are a first team regular, but you're not. You're injured so much. A bit strange, really. I will say that he played well in his last game. And that really got him going, so hopefully he'll take that with him here for this match against the Lewis Hamlet. 5.43 versus 5.70, and we'll do instant result for this one as well. I think we'll go with a 3-0 match the game after this. And let's go with a little bit of a risk and say that we can win, but of course, as I'm saying that to the team, we'll get a goal against us in the first minute and another in the 7th minute, so not too good, but we do come back with a reduction before the end of the first half. So that would mean that the scoreline after one half is 1-2 for Basic versus Dulwich Hamlet. Schultz doing another good match here, but the rest of the squad and not so much. Again, go with a little bit of a risky. We won't let them run away with this game, so we can't lose with more than one goal. Atmosphere are still at 3 only, but hopefully if we hold this together, can get away with only losing by 1 or get a draw. Yeah, losing by 1, I think that will be all right. Overall, I think this, well, we lost 2 speech points. We didn't let them run away with this game, so I think that's overall went well, actually. But the final result for Bassett versus Dulwich Hamlet is 182. And players playing all right overall, I would say. Shots 6-7, shots on target 5-5, chances 6-7, and possession 47-53%. So definitely all right. And yeah, not too unfair result, though, of course, losing that match. I guess it were fair. Unfortunately, dropping down to 20th place in the league, 10 points off from a playoff spot. And dropping further down in terms of sports here. And yeah, shame. And yeah, I think soon we will be fired and this series will be over, or we gotta restart it or something. And do better. Well, at least now we know the tricks to get in a proper lone players and getting rid of everything that we can to save the cash and the cost and everything like that. So I think we could be all right if we're forced to a restart. Of course, now we are pretty committed, so to say, to this save and don't really want to have to restart. That would be definitely a loss for us. But we'll see here. At this current stage, I don't think we can ask for a contract extension, but let's actually have a look at that here. All right. Discuss this. I don't think they will sign a new contract with me, but all right, they do. Currently, well, I want what I having in wage. That's really the only thing. Let's see here. Offer. Well, I will sign it for sure. I could have said that I wanted a longer contract, but I don't care. We want to get in a contract. And the fan popularity dropped there for us getting a longer contract, but all right. So Slowtown at the moment have had a really good season so far. Scouting finished, yeah, highest form gain. Ryan Brown is out, that's not good. 535 anyway, for the first team. Unfortunately, too many injuries here and everything. Team dynamics. Frustrated players in our squad. Yeah, I know that we have many frustrated players in our squad. Can't do too much about it. What should we say to Stacia? Stronger maybe? Yeah, do you take that? Clearly lacking staff, well, that's all right. We'll increase this sum here. 3 years, it's a little bit long, so we'll skip that. We only have 6 more ad spaces to sell, so that's not too bad. Before we start this match, which we will do in 3D match, remember to smash that like button. Like button if you're enjoying FIFA Manager 2020 here. And also hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so yet and want to follow along on our run towards Premier League and beyond. Also, if you're interested in how you can get FIFA Manager up to date, I have a tutorial linked in the description, or just search for FIFA Manager 2020 tutorial on my channel and you will find the video on how you can get it yourself. Of course, that means that you need to have FIFA Manager 2013 or 2014 installed. And there is actually a link in the description where you can get FIFA Manager 2013 or 2014 for a good price as well. And if you buy it from there, I will get a small percentage of the price there. It's a good way to support me as a content creator. So go check that out if you're interested, and we'll get back to this match here, Bath City versus Slowton. And this time, 3D match will only do goals, and I think we'll do 3D match for next match as well, since we're only doing goals. And hopefully we can have a good match here. We definitely need it. Looks like we're doing all right in possession, at least for the first 10 minutes or so. And it's a first goal here for Bassity, and a really good player there, actually, between the forwards. I do think it's Prompt, that, well, Prompt is in here, so it's the Charter. An assist from, we do take the lead in the 15th minute, which is all that matters at the moment, winning in the game. And we get an injury on roster here also, which is not too good at all. We forgot to look at the scouting, and I guess the transfer, I wonder if we still can find the transfer for loans, maybe. I don't know. But we'll have a look straight after this match, actually, and not let it go further on, so to say. Storm can't have been that injured since they let him play for 13 minutes. We should have the end of the first half here, and the second, and we do. So the first half scoreline is 1-0 for Bassett versus Slow Town. That's good for us, of course. And let's continue like this. Play talks, atmosphere up to 8 after the team park, I guess. So a lot better, and teamwork 73. So hopefully we can tie this up.
He's going for
but
goal.
Here it comes. Whatever team we are meeting, Slow Town with a goal. So it's all equal here now, unfortunately. We're very early on also in the second half. So not at all what we wanted to see here. And we really can't afford to lose this game, so hopefully we'll hold it together and come back with a goal here. So really scared to see another highlight, so to say, but also really want to see another highlight. Don't know what will happen if we lose one or two more matches, even though they did prolong our contract. Going kind of really slow, actually, even though it's 4x the match speed. Chances 66 have been quite a fair amount of chances. Slow Town getting a red card there in the 80th minute. Hope we can take advantage of that in this last few minutes. That would be great. And now into extra time.
It's a sparkling run.
And don't seem like we will make it, or is it well something taken. Here? It's the goal for Bassity, and I think this is Dishara here again, and it's definitely in extra time, and definitely the winning goal there. Yeah, it
He's
is. Oh, what a crucial score there, or goal there. So the end score after full time is 2-1 for Bassity versus Slow Town. Shots 8-6, shots on target 3-2, chances 8-6, possession 55-45%, and that brought us up to 17th place in the league, 10 points off from a playoff spot. And where a Slow Town actually in the league? Well, they were better than 16th, but they are 16th now, just above us. And that got defense support up a bit, and also the boards on sport, which is very crucial. But I think our financial safety is looking is pretty important for when they prolong our contract. So Tartford is having a really poor season, so hopefully we can take advantage of that. And we are having far too many players injured here, so we're having a really hard time here. Lineup assistant. What sort of players do we need here in the first team? We need to call up a few players, so right back at 39. Midfielders for the bench. Central defender. Well, energy zero. That's not good. How can you have put a player like that? Best position, right midfielder. Well, he seems to be decent, Russell. Move to first team. Next match. 1 week. And what more here? Left back here. We'll also can't do that for some reason. We'll move Colin Thomas here for 1 week. And what more? Whittle. Can't do that. Evans, can we do... No? Well, we can remove you from squad. Don't really want to do that, though. First team. 519. Right midfielder. Yeah, I think that will have to do, unfortunately. So this is going to be a tough match for sure. And identified another cute player. Offer from elsewhere. We're not going to listen to you. We got a click through all of this. Sorry for that. Reserves team losing pretty badly, but they are playing the same team as we are meeting in the league always, it seems like. Osterham wants to massively improve. Well, then you need to massively do better. You have improved a little bit, but not massively. But what should we tell him? Give us more in training then, I guess. Yeah, obviously motivator. So we finally maybe seem to be nailing these things. So we should do this. Scouting league, yes, please. Nope. Anything that is, well, that is what is longest is what we should do. And I said that we were going to do another 3D match, so we will hear team rating 519 versus 538 for Dartford here. So I want to say get out there and keep it simple. And I think again we will do with the only highlights for the goals. And come on, load the game in, please. Oh, reloading, always fun. We have not won for 12 matches, so they have not a very good run at all, Dartford, at the moment. Actually, lost in the league, I believe. And we have at least conceded one goal in the last 10 league matches. So that's not good either, so... Two struggling teams for sure. So let's see here if we can't get them to kick off. We do. And what now? Oh well, come on. Goals only, please. Oh, so starting off here, we have no possession at all, I see, in the first, well, few minutes. First few minutes is always kind of one-sided, or not always, but it's very easy one-sided But here after a bit more 15 minutes, we're still having real trouble in terms of the position, but we are coming back, and also coming back with a few chances here, so that's good if we're to believe the stats that it's actually showing. Not sure that one should trust that, but we are having 3-1 in terms of chances if we're looking at that. So if we can keep on hammering and take advantage of Dartford's what seems to be extremely poor form, and maybe we can do something here and get away with a win, that would be huge for us really, and maybe be a sort of a turning point here for this season. Chances up to 5 now actually, and it would seem 4 of them hitting the target. Unfortunately, no goal as of yet. But here is a goal, and it is for Bassetti, and Dishara here with another goal for this season, and taking the lead for Bassetti just before the end of the first half. So a superb goal there, a really important one for Bassetti. And we should have the end of the first half here now, in a second. And there we have it. After one half, the scoreline for Bassetti versus Dartford is 1-0. And overall, it looks like the players are playing quite well. And this is just how we imagined this, I would say it is. Atmosphere still at 8, teamwork at a steady 76. So if we're just getting up the atmosphere in the team and having players that aren't getting injured and things like that, I think we are in with a chance to do something good in the league. But yeah, we're obviously kicking ourselves for punishing ourselves with the extremely hard preseason that we're doing against teams like Manchester United and things like that. And unfortunately here, we get a goal against us in the 60-minute mark or so. So it's now all equal. And the chances, Dartford have smashed in the chances here in the second half and are back now. If we're, again, to trust those numbers. So, again, really scared here to see another highlight, because as last time, or as last match, we know that it's going to be a goal if we see a highlight. And I'm kind of pleased with a draw here against Dartford. But it looks like, it's a goal for Bath City here. So we retake the lead here in the 75th minute or something like that. Almost offside situation there 2 times in a row, but managing to stay on the correct line or side of the line there, and Stacia doing his 4th goal of this season. So now I definitely don't want to see another highlight, because the chances are 50-50, I guess, that it's for Bassetti or for Dartford. So 50% chance that the highlight is bad, I don't want a bad highlight. And now we are into the extra time here in the second half, waiting for the final whistle, and there we have it. Bassetti winning again 2-1, and this time against Dartford after full time. And well, first of all, the team playing really well, and again Schultz doing really well here. So really good that he got the momentum going there, and maybe for the whole rest of the team. Shots 12-9, shots on target 9-3, chances 12-10, and possession 43-57. And I would say a pretty well-deserved win, and that brought us up to 16th place in the league. Not much up, but we are now only 7 points off from a playoff spot, and are now back in the runnings, sort of. So that's really good, and good signings is, well, Ostrom is considered a good signing. I wouldn't necessarily say so, but all right. Goodridge, yeah. A very good signing, that's for sure. That is like the players that we would like, and only earning 5k. or only and only, but that's like, it's all right for sure. And sports up to 9, so that's good. And reserves team losing badly, but we don't expect anything else of the reserves team since the reserve team is pretty weak. Anyway, and that will be everything for this episode. So I hope you have enjoyed and thanks so much for watching. I will see you next time. Thank you and bye-bye. You have been watching Rawslowgaming and I hope you have enjoyed. On clicking on the video on the left, you will see the next video in this series, and on the right, our latest upload to the channel. And with that said, thank you again for watching.